Practical applicability in CaCO2 system. Let us demonstrate the relevance of the above derived equations on the example of CaCO2 system presented in the phase equilibria in such three-component system with a single free component, O, can be represented in a so-called quasi-binary, i.e. isoactivity section, phase diagram revealed in B. It exhibits exactly the same topological characteristics as conventional binary phase diagrams of closed systems. On the other hand, if we affix the cation composition and release the free component activity, we get an isoplethyl, that is, T log AF division presented in A, for which X1-4, can be employed. The upper shown two transitions, that is, Ca3Co2O6 plus Ca3Co3.9 plus XO9.3 minus, Ca3Co2O6 plus Ca1 minus XCOXO, and Ca3Co2O6 plus Ca1 minus XCOXO, Ca1 minus XCOXO, number 1 plus number 2, stay as the distinctive sharp transitions, where the Clapeyronian, 1, is relevant. Note that if delta Yo is constant such as in the latter case, the corresponding borderline must by linear in, 1/t, representation and hyperbolic in, t, representation. A, upper, T versus LOCPO 2 phase diagram of CaCO2 system for Ca, Co equals 3 to 3.9, B, bottom, T versus ICO isoactivity section, PO2 equals 0.21, of CaCO2 phase diagram, dashed line, isoplethyl section shown in, A, transferred from ref. By contrast, the lower lying borderline represents a partial phase transition between the solution phase Ca3Co3.9 plus XO9.3 minus, misfit phase, and the two-phase region of this phase in Ca3Co2O6, whose content is vanishing when crossing the boundary. Hence, the first Ehrensteinian equation must be exploited. Clearly, both delta Yo and delta hair 0 at the transition, since the phase fraction of MF psi equals 1 within the single phase region and it began to decrease at the borderline. Hence, differentiating delta Yo equals, psi, 1, Yo plus, 1 psi 6 fifths, equals 0 with respect to ton to ling po, we obtain. And thus, borderline should be linear and provided the delta kappa ot slash delta kappa ratio was constant, which, however, is obviously not the case as seen from A. The dotted line corresponds to the integrated, 4, with this ratio taken constant, delta kappa u slash delta kappa ot equals 28k, as obtained for PO2 equals 0.21 in the respective transition temperature TT equals 1148k. Finally, the both delta kappa ot and delta kappa u are accessible from experiment. Though, if delta kappa ot can be directly evaluated from TGA data recorded at constant PO2, delta kappa or requires a more sophisticated device as is TGA with controlled adjustable PO2 or coulometric titration. If delta kappa u is not available, one can take use of another relation resulting from, 4, explicitly. Having a need of the knowledge of enthalpies of both involved phases as well as gaseous oxygen at the transition temperature. This example is supposed to demonstrate how the presented equations can be applied for the construction of potential phase diagrams from experimental data or for the assessment of thermodynamic quantities necessary for the theoretical calculation of phase equilibria. In conclusion, we can observe from the four new Clapeyronian equations, X1, and, 2, and two additional involving pressure, the providence of Holba, who was able to deduce as many as 28 such pioneering Ehrenfest-like equations published in his last communications and finished just few days before his passing away. It is great pity that such a gifted thermodynamist could not continue publishing his concepts thus far capable of additional publications in the form of future paper. Concisely, let us highlight that the concept of hyperfree energy and a new class of Clapeyron and Ehrenfest-like equations can be found useful for the equilibrium studies in construction of thermodynamic models of non-stoichiometric phases. It became useful for structuring of straightforward phase diagrams reflecting the equilibrium phase relations under a given controlled atmosphere. The impact of Holba toward better understanding of the thermodynamic background of processes and his encouragement of novel thermodynamic portrayal of partly open system is unlocked to a wider attention, laying emphasis on the fact that he was one of the co-founders of the renowned Czech thermodynamic school, CF. It is investigated in the early issues of the local Czech journal Siliky Ceramics published in Prague. Hulba's noteworthy legacy threw out becoming prominent within Russian circles, and it gave stimulus for Hulba's awarding the prestigious Russian Kurnikov Medal of the Russian Academy of Science in the sphere of thermodynamics conferred in memoriam during the 15th International Conference on Thermal Analysis held in St. Petersburg 2016. So, this lecture is also devoted to his commemoration.